About Dogs on BCTV is supported by the Berks County Kennel Club and by the Berks County Dog Training Club.
Good evening and welcome to the Berks County Kennel Club's program, All About Dogs. Hi, I'm Pat Mock, your host, and this evening I have two unusual breeds for you. The first is a Quaker Hunja. Get that, right? And the owner is Rod Beckstead. And my other breed is a Berger Picard. And her owner is Judy Thompson. And I think, first of all, we will talk to Rod and his little Quaker. No, it's not a Quaker. It's a Quaker. Q-O-O-I-K-E-R. We separated the name. It's all one long word. Suppose you tell us, Rod, where this dog is from.
This dog is a very, very old breed. He's from Holland, of all places.
Oh.
As far back, we have him documented back into the 1530s.
Oh, my word.
And it's a very unusual breed in that it has been developed to procure ducks by luring ducks off the canals, down tributaries, into traps. The Quaker would then occupy or would take them for market.
Okay, so it's actually a hunting dog?
It's not, well, yes and no.
Oh, okay.
It's a game, all right. A game procuring dog.
Okay.
Except the game follows the dog.
Okay. Then they actually, nobody shoots the ducks.
Nope.
They take them to market live.
Well, after they're trapped in their nets, I think they are
okay.
Dispatched before
okay.
they take
okay.
them
okay.
to market.
Well, that's a nice way to say it.
But it's an unusual breed in that it just lures
uh-huh.
the ducks. It's because of the coloration
okay.
and the action going down the side of canals. The tail is very animated.
Uh-huh.
And the interesting way that they work is the traps, the net area,
uh-huh.
has been set up with blinds. And so the dog is trained to go in and out of these blinds, and so the ducks actually will see them, then they'll lose track of them and can't find them any longer. And then the dog will reappear further down the trap a ways, and the ducks, the curiosity, they follow them down
yeah.
to
yeah.
see where he is.
Well, I think you brought a picture of that along with you.
Yes.
Do you have the picture there? Can we show the picture? I think it's to me it didn't make sense because I've never been to Holland and I didn't exactly know what he was talking about. But there you yeah. can see the dog and the ducks you can see in the water behind the dog.
Right.
And the way Rod explained, the dog runs in and out of those
baffles,
like rafters.
In and out the reed
that
reed
panels. Brown things on either side mm-hmm. and the ducks just swim after the dog trying to find out what he's doing.
Right.
If any of you know the Nova Scotia duck tolling retriever, I think this is a relative.
Yes, this is a precursor breed.
Okay.
This dog was actually in the very early 1800s, was taken into the Maritime Islands.
Okay.
Before the French and Indian War.
Mm-hmm.
And then the Scots came in, took over the island, kicked the French people out, unfortunately, and kept the dogs, and then started inbreeding this dog with all of the sporting dogs
okay.
and developed the Nova Scotia Duck Tolling Retriever.
Uh-huh, uh-huh.
The thing that I find quite interesting in that entire time frame of all of the other breeds that are brought into it, the one thing that remains true is that ability to lure the ducks. And
okay.
of course, that is the unique part of the Nova
Scotia
toller,
yep.
is luring the ducks into
right.
the hunters.
Yeah, ducks are pretty dumb because they, you know,
actually,
they just come in to see. It's like, okay.
Canadian geese will also toll.
Uh-huh.
And we used to do a lot of our practice work down on Lake Nockamixon Reservoir, and we have actually lured Canadian geese completely across that reservoir.
Oh, my word.
Nearly a mile across.
Yeah.
Just from the activity on the
right.
side of the bank.
Well, I guess, too, because the dogs aren't actually chasing them.
No.
They're doing just the opposite. They're playing and paying no attention.
That's exactly
so
right.
So the ducks and the geese come in. They could use you on the golf course. Well, no, they want them off the golf
they
course.
Want
not
them
on
off.
The golf course.
They
So How popular is this breed?
Gaining.
Okay.
We are now hoping to be accepted into the miscellaneous class in AKC this month.
Oh, good.
There are probably in the neighborhood of 250 of these dogs in the country.
Okay.
We have isolated and got memberships with almost 200 of them.
Uh-huh.
And so it's going and growing very nicely. And unfortunately, there are very few breeders here in the country.
Yes.
But it just makes the dog a little more exciting to have. Mm-hmm.
Well, he wasn't born here.
No, he came from Switzerland. I actually, I bought two females from a breeder here in the States.
Uh-huh.
Wasn't really excited about the future of the breed from what I saw. So I went back to some of the older breeders in Europe and got him from a breeder in Switzerland. And it was just kind of fun as we negotiated because I didn't speak Swiss German. They didn't speak English.
Uh-huh.
But it's amazing how computers can work.
Yes.
And we talked very, very well, and we were able to talk to each other once we got
mm-hmm,
there.
Mm-hmm.
And when I first saw him, he was at the airport in Zurich. And
so you actually bought him sight unseen?
Yes.
Okay.
Yes, I went with a good breeder from over there that I knew
and
well.
They were the ones who
they
told you
evaluated
that.
Yes. For
okay.
me.
Okay.
And then they gave me the pick of the litter, actually.
Okay.
But when I first saw him at the airport, two ladies had two puppies, and they introduced him as Iron, rolling the R. And so by incorporating all of our kennel names and their kennel name and the regulations they had to deal with, this little tiny boy's official name is Iron Ravenswood von Wichtelhaus.
Yeah.
So we got everybody in and still kept him as
the
individual.
Name is longer than the dog.
Absolutely.
I just expected that they would be larger. I had never seen one. And I just expected when you say a hunting dog to me, that's always bigger. Although,
right.
You know, so many of the spaniels are little. So it's like, okay, well, they require a lot of grooming?
No.
Okay.
One of the very nice things about it is a
dual-coated
dog.
Okay.
So twice a year, usually, they will shed out that undercoat.
Mm-hmm.
And in about a week, you're done with it. But they keep themselves so very, very clean, very much cat-like
mm-hmm.
in their cleaning. And I use it as a brag point and not in a shame point at all, but this dog has not had a bath for over a year.
Mm-hmm.
Although he's been outside, he's been doing all the dog stuff in the pastures and everything else.
Mm-hmm.
But their coat is such that when it gets wet, gets muddy, dries off, and usually 20 minutes to a half an hour later, you've got a clean dog.
Yeah.
And they clean themselves very cat-like.
Yeah. Well, I think, too, a lot of the dogs that do go in the water, like your retrievers, I think they have a tendency to be cleaner. Not because they went in the water, but because of the oils in their coat. They seem to have a much more oily coat than
yes.
some of the other breeds
yes.
that, you know, don't go in the water. Are they easy to train? He's got such a beautiful face. He has his hand on his face, so you can't really see his face.
Here,
and
Iron.
He's showing us his tail.
Come
so,
here,
you
let's
know.
See this boy.
Isn't he
Sit.
A pretty dog? I think he's just such a pretty dog. He's got such a pretty, he looks almost like a spaniel.
Actually, the furthest back that we can go is some reference back in the 1600s that it may have come from an Italian spaniel.
Okay, okay.
But, you know, so that's,
right,
you're absolutely right.
But where did that, the tolling characteristic come from? You know, it's
exactly.
it's just, right, that's exactly right.
One of the marks that kind of sets this breed off is we call them earrings, the black hair on the ears. Now, he's not quite as good of an example as down here, which is a picture of him about 2 years ago, because last summer he helped a young lady raise a litter of eight puppies.
There you can see his dark ears.
Yeah, you can see a bit there,
That's good. That's beautiful.
And the puppy's pretty well chewed off all his black ears, but he's coming back. And
there you can see it good.
It's kind of a little distinguishing mark
yes.
On the dog. Which,
now, do they only come in that color?
They're all in, well, it's described as a white dog with a predominance of red color.
Oh, okay.
Must have the eyes, cheeks, and ears all covered.
Okay.
And must have a black nose, black eyes.
Okay.
Can have the blaze on the face.
Okay.
The rest of the body can be any color or any combination of red and white.
Okay. Because I do see the spotting on his legs as well.
Right, right. They can have a bit of freckling.
Uh-huh.
And in younger dogs, there sometimes is a black ring between the red and white on their tail.
Okay, okay.
And they tend to lose that
as they get older. Yeah.
And
Are they easy to train?
Very.
Really?
It's a very, very intelligent dog. They do great in all the performance events.
Uh-huh.
In fact, our first AKC title was a mock obedience title.
Oh, wow.
From a young lady down in Florida in agility. They're extremely rapid.
Uh-huh.
They like to participate in any of those kind of activities.
Uh-huh.
And that's why we kind of call it sometimes a perfect mother-in-law dog, because it's small enough.
Uh-huh.
It doesn't drag mother-in-law around when they're out walking, but it does like to go out and have activities.
Uh-huh.
Loves to ride in the car, loves to do that sort of thing. Once it comes back in the house, you can see this is pretty much the demeanor.
Really?
Love to cuddle. Fireplaces are good to sit by.
Yeah.
And it's just a very likable dog.
Yeah.
They like to know where you are and maybe be in the same room with you in the house, but they're not attached to you at all times.
Not pushy.
And very, very trainable. And
so how much exercise does he actually require? I would assume a fenced yard.
Absolutely.
Right.
We have actually we have three different sections of our property that's fenced for different activities. And if this dog could have a half an hour in the backyard chasing balls, retrieving, that sort of thing, that would be perfectly adequate exercise for them. Of course, you kind of base that on a lot of how much exercise can you do with them as well.
Okay.
If it's just a walk, fine. I have a couple of folks that I know that own them that jog with them, and they might go 3-4 miles a day, and the dogs keep up with them. So it's all a matter of conditioning and what your activity happens to be.
Well, how much does he weigh?
Average size, and he's right in the middle, 24 pounds.
Okay.
The standard calls for a dog between 14 to 16 inches tall and 20 to 25 pounds.
Okay.
There are a few in the country that are larger than that.
Mm-hmm.
A lot of the very, very early expert dogs that were imported, exported from some of the countries in Europe, don't fit the standard as well as we're working for it now.
Okay.
The Quaker Club has been doing a lot of work in importing new bloodlines, a lot of new pedigrees, and although our breeding stock right now, because there's only six breeders in the entire country.
Oh, wow.
So our breeding stock now is not producing a lot of puppies.
Right.
But we're hoping that within this two-year time period, when all these imports get grown up, get certified, get all the health care and everything taken
well,
care of.
Well, you definitely need a larger gene pool than just, you know.
Absolutely.
Right, right. Because I know they had that with the Basenjis.
Yes.
And they went back to Africa to bring in more Basenjis because of the problems that were developing with constantly, you know, breeding
that
the same gene pool.
Keep replicating the same
problems.
That's exactly what we're trying to work away from.
Well, what health problems do these guys have?
Probably the two that we're most watching for is von Willebrand's disease, which is a blood dyscrasia disease.
Mm-hmm.
And the other, of course, would be the eyes.
Okay.
And
PRA or?
Yes, PRA. Okay. Of course, again, we watch that very carefully.
Okay, I didn't know if it was PRA or cataracts.
Yeah, PRA.
Okay.
And fortunately with the von Willebrands, we have a DNA marker.
Good.
We can all do the blood test.
Okay, well hold that thought. We need to take a break. So we'll be right back. Stay tuned.
You're watching All About Dogs on bctv.org. Be informed, be involved, be a member. For membership information, go to www.bctv.org/support/membership. For more information and other stories about animals and pets, go to www.bctv.org. All About Dogs is underwritten by the Berks County Kennel Club and by Berks Dog Training Club. For more information on how you and your business can become program underwriters, go to www.bctv.org.
And we're back. So, you were talking about the eye problems, the von Willebrand's, right. You have a marker for.
Right.
Von Willebrand's is hemophilia. That's what von
Basically.
Willebrand's is.
Yep.
It's the bleeding disease, hemophilia.
The other one that is known in a lot of the European dogs as well, it's called ENM, which is a neuromuscular disease that may come on usually a little later in life, somewhat
okay.
like muscular dystrophy.
Okay, like a wasting disease.
Yes.
Okay.
We have a DNA marker for that
Very
also.
Very good.
The University at UTEC mm-hmm. in Holland has done a fantastic job in researching the genes of this breed.
Wonderful.
And we do all our blood testing over there
mm-hmm.
just because they're the experts.
Yeah.
And so the major problems that we have DNA markers.
Wonderful.
So we can, with all of the import dogs as
yes.
well as those
mm-hmm.
bred here,
right.
we can certainly make sure that the breeding stock as well as the puppies
mm-hmm.
are free from these diseases.
With the DNA markers that they're finding in all these different breeds, I mean, we've made such progress. It's just unbelievable. Okay, well, how about we talk about our little critter on this side. This is a Berger Picard. So, Judy, suppose you tell us what a Berger Picard is,
well,
other than having huge ears.
She's pretty well grown into her. She was 7 months old on March 1st.
Okay.
Probably what made this breed so famous, and there's only about 450 in the United States. And we got into the miscellaneous category January of 2013.
Okay.
And hopefully moving into the herding group in mid 2015.
Okay.
So you're a little rare, but the movie Because of Winn-Dixie in 2005
okay.
was what really got the popularity of this breed going in the United States. And that particular movie was a fawn color.
Uh-huh.
They come in a variety of colors, from very, very light fawn to a dark brindle,
okay.
which she is,
okay.
and all in between.
Okay. Do you think she can stand up so we can see her brindling?
Curious.
All the while, this program, as soon as they walked in the door, she had this rawhide with her, and she has been chewing this rawhide for the last, what, hour? So if you want a Berger, you better get up, sweetheart,
Come
so
on,
we
babe.
Can see what you look like.
Come on.
There you
go.
There. Now, this is a fairly large dog.
She will max out at about 23 and a half inches
okay.
for a female, somewhere between 55 and 60 pounds.
Okay.
And a male will run somewhere between 60 to 70 pounds at about 25 and a half inches max.
Mm-hmm.
They're full of energy, needless
yeah.
to say. But you let them out in the yard, run long walks, jogging, and when you bring them in, they're pretty quiet in the house and pretty
okay.
docile.
Okay.
If you want to have privacy, this is not the breed for you.
Oh.
They love you. They're your best buddies. They want to be with you. In fact, you have to be careful in socializing in that you teach them not to constantly be with you.
Okay.
Because if you go away, you don't
yes.
want the fear
yes.
and anxiety.
Yes.
Properly socialized, they're great with children. She would probably rather play with children than have treats.
Mm-hmm.
Other dogs, properly socialized, are good with other dogs.
Well, kids are more fun, let's face it,
oh,
you know.
Definitely.
Girls just want to have fun,
that's
right, kids?
Right.
Yeah.
That's right. Come here. She wants
and
to play.
And she's strong.
So you were telling me about the, this is a herding dog then. Where has it come from?
This is an ancient French breed.
Okay.
They know that they date back to the 9th century and before.
Okay.
They almost became extinct during World War I and World War II,
like
a lot of breeds over in Germany.
Okay.
And one interesting thing was during the wars, they would actually shave their backs down and smuggle in goat pouches with the goat hair up, like tobacco and matches across the lines.
Huh.
So that was pretty unique.
Yeah. And a black dog, obviously, you know, you're not going to see it at night.
Mm-hmm.
That's exactly right. So then do they herd sheep
mainly, cattle, some have even been taught to herd ducks and geese.
Okay. Because they remind me very much of the Briard,
yes.
Which is the French sheepdog. Is her coat going to get longer, or is it going to stay?
It will get about 2.5-3 inches long.
Okay.
They don't have very, very little grooming. The only grooming that you would have is when the ear hair gets really long, it has a tendency to weigh the ears down,
okay.
So you would pluck out a little of the ear hair. The standard calls for you're supposed to be able to see the outline of the ear.
Okay. So is this a natural ear?
Yes, this is natural.
Okay.
Everything must be natural on this breed. She has what is her adolescent coat. It's, you can see up here that it's starting to lay very nice, and back here it's still coming in.
Right.
Again, one
double
of the
coated
dogs that doesn't need a lot of baths. She's had one bath
for
this particular show and upcoming shows this weekend. but outside of that, very low maintenance, brushing once a month. I do it more to teach her right now, but very low maintenance. They're a very healthy breed.
Okay.
We do keep close tabs on the hips, as you would at any large breed dog, but pretty healthy, and the eyes again.
Okay.
But outside of that, that's one of the reasons I picked her. Very few health problems.
Good.
With the breed. They haven't overbred them yet. They are very intelligent, but they can be also very much a clown, just like that.
Just like that.
And a little bit of a stubborn streak.
No, she's not telling the truth, is she? No, she's not telling the truth.
But very, very much a sweetheart.
Her coat's not wiry. Is she double-coated?
Yes, she is.
Okay. Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Short, dense undercoat, and then the longer coat. And as she matures, it will get a little more wiry.
Okay. So at her age, she needs a lot of exercise.
Yes.
Right? Okay.
Yes. Actually, with the larger, once they're more mature, in fact, her obedience trainer already suggested the doggy backpacks, where you can fill them with water bottles or sandbags, just because of that athletic. They're extremely, extremely athletic dogs.
Okay. What else did I want to ask you? Oh, the temperament. Obviously, she is friendly.
Very.
Would they be good guard dogs? Would this be a good apartment dog? Would this be a dog that's good for older people? I know that's three questions in a row.
They're very, very good guard dogs.
Okay.
They want to please their owner. They're extremely protective of their owner, just like they would be of the sheep.
Okay.
Driving into Reading today, she started barking once people started getting near the car. In terms of apartment, as long as you're going to go out and exercise them several times a day, they adjust very well in apartments.
So they're not barkers?
No.
Okay.
No. Older people, as long as you're mobile and can get out and exercise them or have a dog walker. In fact, there's some people in the club that are getting up in age, and they're doing very well with theirs.
Okay.
It's just the initial training. It can be a handful.
Yes. And it's a puppy.
But with most dogs, you have that.
Yeah. Some puppies aren't quite as, you know, wild as. And you said you started out small with Skipper Keys and went bigger and bigger and bigger. And I never had a small dog. Well, I shouldn't say that. I had a medium-sized dog. But I always liked the bigger dogs. But sometimes this breed would be the best kind of dog for an older dog. You just sort of have to know what your lifestyle is. So, is this breed very popular?
Like I said, there's only about 450 in the United States.
But as far as breeders?
Breeders,
Are there more than six?
Yes, there's much more than six. I'm going to say maybe about 20.
Okay.
I actually haven't counted them. Still, for a rare breed, they're fairly hard to come by. I did research for a year and a half before I decided on this breed, and then waited another year for the litter.
Uh-huh.
Did a lot of flying back and forth between Milwaukee and here, because I got her from a breeder in Milwaukee.
Okay. Her ears are just astounding, aren't they?
That's one of the characteristics of the breed. The ears, the tail. If she would turn around, you could see her beard. It's very scruffy looking.
Yes.
And most people think that they're mutts.
Yeah.
And personally, I don't care if we stick that way, then we won't have a lot of overbreeding.
That's exactly right. And that's exactly what they look like. They mm-hmm. they look like little, you know, little, well, what kind of mix is that, you know?
Yep.
But reminds you of a Schnauzer,
mm-hmm.
sort of reminds you of a Schnauzer. But she does have very dark eyes. And
yes, that's the another characteristic. The standard says the darker the eyes, the better.
Oh,
it has something tied in to do with prey.
Okay.
Because a lot of the animals in the wild have the lighter color eyes.
Uh-huh, uh-huh.
So a dog that's into herding is supposed to have the darker eyes.
Okay.
I found that very interesting.
Yeah.
That's something I didn't know with my Schipperkes or Belgians.
Yeah. Huh. I don't know. I've never heard it either.
Yeah.
Isn't that interesting? Mm-hmm. So why did you get this breed then?
I was looking for a good guard dog. I was looking for a companion. The knees have gone in the show ring from this little Schipperkes, so I was looking for a bigger one. I wanted, I preferred the pricked ears because of ear infections.
Yes, yes.
I wanted intelligence. I wanted a healthy, athletic dog, but something, a breed that had to be very excellent with children.
Okay, okay.
It just had to be, and I have two Skips at home that are seniors, so she had to be good, he or she had to be good with other dogs.
Yeah, yeah.
And she fit every one of my criteria.
Wonderful. Very
so
good.
I was pleased.
Very good. So, anyhow, we hope we got you interested in two unusual breeds. If you are thinking of this breed, either breed, let it be known that you may have to wait a year, 2 years, maybe 3 years for the Quaker. I mean, there's only six breeders. You go on a list and you wait. So, but if this you think this is the breed for you, and you know, if you call the Kennel Club, I will be more than happy to give you either Rod or Judy's name, depending which breed that you're interested in, and you can talk to them all you want. I'm sure they can give you all the information you need about either breed, and what the good points are, what the bad points are. You know, we sort of only touch on that here. But before we go, I do want to, for anybody who has dachshunds out there, the Be More Wieners, okay, presents a Spring Doggy Fest. This is at the Baltimore Humane Society, and they're just going to have all kinds of activities just for dachshunds. They're going to have fly ball, agility, they're going to have foster dogs to adopt, the costume contest, tricks, so at wiener races, of course. So if any of you are interested, again, call the Kennel Club and I will be more than happy to give this information to you. So next month we're going to be talking about our annual match show, so we'll have some puppies on. But until next month, good night.
All About Dogs on BCTV is supported by the Berks County Kennel Club and by the Berks County Dog Training Club.